Our next talk is Phil Watson. He's talking about fostering.
Yeah, that's an awful link. Thanks for that. Hello, everybody. In real life, when I'm not a foster carer, I'm a secondary school teacher, so I'm quite prepared for you to give me any grief you want. You can heckle, you can abuse me, but you can't talk to your best friend on the front row. Hey, I'm talking, you're if... Anyway, do what you want, mate. Okay, what have these people or creatures in these slides got in common? You recognise him, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Who is he? Padding. Now, if you're old like me, you can remember the old cartoon one that used to be on at 5:40. That's the modern animation one. So Paddington arrives in London. He's got no friends. He's got no family. He's got a little thing around his neck that says who he is. Do you know who that is? John Lennon. He's quite well known. He's famous. He was a real person. He lived in Liverpool. He was in a band. Yeah, good. The Beatles. Do you know that he basically couldn't live with his mum and his dad? His dad left and disappeared. His mum couldn't look after him. He went to live with his auntie Mimi. These are superheroes. They all have something in common. I don't know who all of them are, but Superman and Spider-Man and Batman, none of them got to live with their real birth parents when they were growing up. Luke and Leia, very, very famous. It's one of the biggest TV film franchises that we've ever produced. We've already had Darth Vader mentioned. They didn't have a very stable upbringing, putting it bluntly. All got a bit wrong for them. In fact, they seem to fancy each other for some of the films. These are, I don't know, looking at the demographic, do you know who these people are? They're all basically princesses. If you've got a daughter, she would have dressed as one of these in one of their guises. So you've got Snow White, Cinderella, Rapunzel. Often they're based on Walt Disney, who nicked the idea from the Brothers Grimm. Do you know this film? Do you know Despicable Me? Yes, you do. Do you? Yes. He got to choose between world domination and looking after foster kids. He chose well. He chose looking after kids that didn't have a mum and a dad. Is this kid totally famous? Harry Potter ended up living under the stairs with his naughty, evil, and overweight uncle and aunt. Very, very famous child who didn't get to live with a mum and a dad. Do you want to sing a song? Yeah, which one do you want to sing? Okay, so it's the Van Trapp family who lived just with their dad. I think their mum has died. Always interested that their dad was something in the Austrian Navy. If you know anything about geography, you'll know Austria hasn't got a bloody sea. So what he does, I don't know. There's James Bond. James Bond, we only really find this out late in his life, in his films. He has no family. He has almost certainly an attachment disorder, which is why he can either kill people or fuck them. And he doesn't care. He doesn't care. First foster child. I shouldn't have sworn. My mum's going to be cross. Who's that? Moses, possibly the first foster child in history. Mum didn't know if he stays with us, he's not going to live. Push him into the sea. And just in case you want to read any more, there's loads and loads and loads and loads and loads and loads. If you look at your popular culture, wherever you're from, books, films, literature, religion, whatever it might be, we all seem to love learning and reading and finding about the orphan. Very general term. So somebody who can't live with their birth parents. We love reading about them. We love watching them. We can't necessarily identify them, but we want them to win. Harry Potter's a very good example. Tolkien talks about them as well. So anyway, I can't remember what was meant to be under there. I'm not an IT teacher. That's me. Several years ago, my wife said to me, we're over 21. We've got a clean criminal record. We've got a spare room. We're healthy. Shall we foster? I went, no, I don't want to do that. It looks really difficult. I don't even know what it is. And my wife said, come along to an information evening. I went, if you organise it, I'll go, because it sounds like a date. We then went to a Skills to Foster meeting. We found out more. I said to my wife, she knows more stuff than me. She's clever. Your wives are clever too. Why don't we go with an agency? And she said, because there are private agencies. You know what they are. They advertise. They charge your council, Liverpool, millions. And I mean 10, 12 million pounds a year to look after the kids that we can look after ourselves. So my family said, yes, let's foster. I've got two birth children, or children, as I call them. We can. It appeals to my sense of justice. People respect me. I know, it's amazing, isn't it? And so one day we had a foster child. I'm going to cry in a minute. It was very quiet in our house. Can you feel the emotion? And I thought, there's a quiet child. This is bad. He'd smashed the glass of a family photo. He'd got a Sharpie pen. He added himself. Exactly. Now you're R-ing, and I said, that I want to do something about it. So I've become a foster carer. That's my wife. That's my birth daughter. That's actually a birth son, but they blitzed him out of the picture because they didn't know any better. This is Liverpool City Council's website. This is me, Phil Watson. I am a foster carer. My friend Sue is here as well. She is a foster carer. 27 years, 30 children, a world record. It isn't actually, but it's a bloody good record. And my last anecdote is this. I was at a comedian's once, and I was with my wife. It was another hot day, and a comedian was going around taking the mick out of people, and he said to me, you know, you, all right, what do you do? What's your name? And I went, my name's Phil. I'm a foster carer. And he went, fucking typical. I picked the one person in the room that I can't skit. If you want to know more, find me later. All right, thank you very much.